Hi everybody, I'm Lisa. Behind the camera is Bill. Together we are Billisa. Welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. We are back here at Disneyland today and we have something very interesting for you. Because it is Halloween time here at Disneyland, we thought it would be really interesting to share with you some of the ghost stories and the haunted things that have happened here over the years. So we have done some research and looked into some things and we have some stories for you. They say this is the happiest place on earth, but some people call it the happiest haunted place on earth. Let's get started. This building behind me started out as Carousel of Progress, but in 1974, it switched to America Sings. Currently, it is Star Wars Launch Bay, where you can go in and meet Star Wars characters and see a lot of items on display. But my story goes back to 1974, when this building switched to America Sings. 1 week after it switched, an 18-year-old cast member named Deborah Stone actually was crushed between a rotating wall and a stationary wall, and she passed away inside the ride. Of course, they made a lot of changes after reopening the ride. The ride was closed for a couple of weeks so that they had time to make breakaway walls and change some things so that there were lights that would go off if cast members in the future got closer to the openings and if there was any concern for their safety. They wanted to make sure that something like this did not ever happen again. However, since her death in 1974, this land has had a ghost in it, and there are myths that every once in a while, as you walk through this land, you will hear a whisper of someone telling you to be careful or to watch out. And it is believed that that is Deborah making sure to keep people in this land safe. She doesn't want anything like that ever to happen again, so she now resides in Tomorrowland, trying to watch out for the guests and the cast members. America Sings ultimately closed in 1988 and never came back, and it wasn't actually until just recently, a couple of years ago, that this building reopened for Star Wars Launch Bay, which is what still remains there today. Our next ghost story took place here, right on the tracks of the monorail. In 1966, there was a young boy, he was 16 years old, by the name of Thomas Cleveland. There were a lot of grad nights taking place here at Disneyland in the area, and some of his friends that he knew from other schools were going to be here. He was only 16 years old, so he wasn't invited to come yet because he wasn't graduating. But he was going to get into Disneyland one way or another. So Thomas decided to jump on the tracks after climbing over a fence in order to try to enter Disneyland. He was running along the tracks when a security guard noticed him, tried to warn him and let him know that the monorail was coming and that he needed to jump from the track for safety. Actually, Thomas decided not to jump from the track and instead tried to go beneath the track and hang on while he was still suspended. Unfortunately, Thomas did not get away from the track in time, and the area that he chose to lay right below the track was far too close to the track and he ended up getting run over. It is said that still to this day, every once in a while, people will notice a ghost of Thomas inside the monorail riding with them. Our next ghost story took place right here at the Matterhorn bobsled. In 1984, a woman by the name of Dolly Young was riding the Matterhorn with her family. She was in the back seat. They believe that partway through the ride, she unbuckled her seatbelt to check on one of her children, As she went through a dip, she was thrown from the ride and run over by the next bobsled on the track next to her. It is said that still to this day, cast members that are closing the park, they don't want to be on the Matterhorn bobsled ride for closing, because this is one of the rides that after closing, everything is shut down, the lights are turned on, but the ride sound and the ride itself is stopped. Cast members have to walk the tracks to see if anyone lost anything, to make sure everything is cleaned up in there. It is said that after hours, after the park closes, you can still hear her. Sometimes you can hear her moaning or crying. And as well, there are times that they can even just feel a cold wind come through or someone brush up against them. And it is believed to be Dolly. The cast members actually refer to that dip in the ride as Dolly's dip. Additionally, this is one of the reasons that they have different seatbelts in rides, because like I said, it's believed that she actually unbuckled her own seatbelt, and now you're unable to do that. Most rides, if you even try to unbuckle it, a sensor goes off and the ride is stopped immediately to make sure that everybody is safe. But like I said, they still say to this day, Dolly still haunts the ride inside Matterhorn bobsled. Our next ghost story has to do with the light you just saw in the window. I've moved over here because there are so many people over there, but this story is a little less of a ghost story and a little more of a love story. It is about Walt Disney, because even though he passed away in 1966, he has not been able to leave the park that he loves so much. It is said that shortly after he passed away, cast members would hear the words, "I'm still here," whispered throughout the park, and it would be such a nice warm feeling, and they just knew that it had to be Walt Disney. But one story that is really incredible is that I've told you in the past that the light up in that window is in the window of Walt's apartment. And when Walt was living, he would always have that light on when he was here at the park so that guests would know he was here visiting or working. After he passed away, a cast member went up there, it was actually a custodian at the park, went up to clean the room. Before she left the room, she turned the light off, went downstairs, and she looked back up at the window and the light was back on. It's said that when she went back up, she turned the light off again, came back downstairs, looked up, and noticed that the light was on again. This time, obviously, she knew that she had remembered to turn the light off. So she went up, turned the light off, turned around before she left the apartment, and before she could even make it downstairs, the light was back on again. Ever since that day, in memory of Walt, the cast members have decided to leave that light lit every day, because it is clear that he is still here and watching over the place that he loves. We've now made it to the next location of another ghost story we have for you. In 1973, an 18-year-old named Bogdan Delarue and his 10-year-old brother took the raft over to Tom Sawyer's Island. While they were there later on in the evening, they actually climbed the fence into the cabin area and were able to find a place to hide. They stayed there until after the park closed, but shortly after closing, the 10-year-old actually started to get scared and wanted to go back. So they decided to swim across the rivers of America to get back to this side of Disneyland. While they were doing this though, Bogdan realized that his 10-year-old brother was not a good enough swimmer to make it all the way across. So Bogdan decided to carry his 10-year-old brother on his back across. He made it about 3/4 of the way and he could not swim any longer. He was just completely out of breath. Unfortunately, he had taken in so much water that he did end up drowning, but in the meantime, the 10-year-old was splashing around and doggy paddling enough to get the attention of a cast member who was able to rescue him, so he survived. Bogdan's body was actually not found until the next morning. There's actually as well a story of a female that is said to have gone across, decided to stay the night over there, and got cold came back across but didn't quite make it and ended up drowning because she was so cold and the water was so cold. It's really unsure which of these two are actually the ones that are haunting the waters in the rivers of America, but it has been said by numerous cast members that late at night as they're walking through the park after it's closed, there is rippling in the water when the water is perfectly still, and they are certain that it is either Bogdan or it is this unknown female who is haunting the rivers of America. Our last ghost story, quite fittingly, is right here at the Haunted Mansion. When you're in the Haunted Mansion, they very clearly say that there are 999 haunts and that there's room for one more. So there are a lot of people whose last request is to be cremated and for their ashes to be sprinkled inside the Haunted Mansion so that they can be the 1,000th ghost here. Well, it is said that a mother's 6-year-old son, this was his favorite ride, and this was where she wanted to lay his ashes. It was very tragic that unfortunately he died outside the park at a very, very young age, being that he was only 6. But the story goes that the mother rode the Haunted Mansion and sprinkled his ashes inside the ride. It has been said that many guests and many cast members have actually seen this very small boy crying as you leave the ride. It has additionally been said that another wife, her husband's last wish was to be sprinkled here as well. So not only did she do that, but she left the urn inside the Haunted Mansion in the graveyard scene. A cast member found the urn and it was actually taken into the cast member's room for quite some time inside the Haunted Mansion until finally one day the cast members climbed up high above the graveyard scene and placed the urn up above, out of the way where no one could see, but it is said that that urn still sits there today. Cast members have discouraged guests for many, many years not to sprinkle ashes in there because that then becomes a process of cleaning up and having to take care of a mess like that while the park is closed before the ride opens again the next day. But nonetheless, people continue to do it. And that is why they believe at night when the ride is off, they hear sounds and they feel things brushing up against them as they are checking the ride for anything that's been left behind. I do think this is a very great place to end our video and to tell you about our last ghost story that we have. I hope you enjoyed it. It's really, really fun to learn all of these amazing things about Disneyland, and I hope that you have liked learning about it and feel that that makes your holiday season a little more spooky. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so, so much for watching our video. And once again, I'm Lisa. Behind the camera is Bill, and together we are Billisa. Bye!